Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at some questions involving angles in quadrilaterals. So to be able to go through these questions today, we need to understand one of our important angle rules, and that is that angles in a quadrilateral, so that's angles in any four-sided shape, will always add up to 360 degrees. So let's use that now to have a go at some of these questions. So for this first question, we want to work out the size of the angle marked X. While using our rule that angles in a quadrilateral will always add up to 360, all we have to do in this scenario is add up the angles we know, and then once we find that total, we can then take that away from 360. So all I'm going to do here is take my 103, add it onto the 73 and the 109, and that'll give me 285. So we know so far these angles add up to 285, so to find the remaining one, all we need to do is take that away from 360. So if we do 360, take away that 285, we end up with 75. So our missing angle marked X for this particular question would be 75 degrees. Okay, for this next question, we're going to figure out the missing angle X again. Again, we've got three angles of the quadrilateral. So to find the missing one, again, we're just going to add up the values we know and take that away from 360. So we're going to do 110 plus 105 plus 81. And that's going to give us 296. So then all we simply do is take our 360 and take away that 296. And that's going to leave us with 64. So our missing angle here would be 64 degrees. Okay, for this next question, we're finding the missing angle X again. We can see we've got 57 degrees in that bottom right corner. But then for the angles on the left-hand side, we've got two right angles. So we need to use the fact that a right angle is 90 degrees, and we've got two of them. So what we're going to do for this one is we're going to take our two right angles of 90 degrees, and we're going to add them together. And we're then going to add on that 57 degrees as well. And once we do that, we get 237. So we know that our three angles that we've been given added together add up to 237. And because we know the angles in this quadrilateral will add up to 360, we're simply just going to take it away. So we do 360, take away 237. And that's going to give us 123. So our missing angle X here is 123 degrees. Okay, and for this final question, again, we're finding this missing angle marked X. Again, in this quadrilateral, we can see we've got two angles that we've been given on the interior, which is 121 and 61. But then we've got this exterior angle of 245. So what we're going to do here is actually figure out this angle first. And we can use another angle fact to help us figure this out. Because we know this exterior angle is 245 degrees, we can figure out this missing angle here by using angles around a point. So angles around a point will always add up to 360 degrees. So what we're going to do is take our 360 degrees and take away our exterior angle, which in this case is 245. And once we do that, that gives us 115. So this interior angle here would actually be 115 degrees. So now that we've got three out of the four angles, we can use the method that we've been using previously. We're going to add together the angles that we know in our quadrilateral. So we've got 121 plus 115 plus 61, and that's going to give us 297. And then just like before, we know our angles in our quadrilateral are going to add up to 360. So all we're going to do now is take this 297 away from that 360. And when we do that, we're left with 63. So for this question, our missing angle marked X would be 63 degrees. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any of my other videos on angles, then I've left some links for them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. Well, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.